A story of angel love. Once upon a time, in a beautiful, beautiful mountain town, there lived a farm family with two children, a girl and a boy. They played in the fields and in the barns and in the pond and the pasture and had a great, great life, helping with the gardens, feeding the chickens, and milking the cows. What a happy life. All of a sudden, this changed one day when two garden fairy angels appeared to them and said, "From now on, you will be given a test. The kids at school will bully you both for reasons that you don't understand. We will be there with you and will watch how you handle this unhappy situation. And remember, ask us for help, and we will fly to your side and advise you, okay?"
The two children, Samantha and Miguel, looked into each other's puzzled eyes and wondered how their life would change. "Don't be afraid, Miguel," said Samantha, "and remember that the angel fairies promised to help us. Let's climb our favorite tree and think about how we will handle this new challenge."
The tree was close to the ground and had a ladder next to it. Plus, they had permission from their parents to climb to the lowest branch so they wouldn't fall. They enjoyed their time there day after day and would even do their homework in the tree. Everything was fine, and then 6 months later, school became very upsetting. They each were being bullied a few times a week. Remembering that they had helpers, they climbed their tree and asked the fairy angels to come to them. "Help, help, we need help. Help, help, we need help. Help! Help! We need help!" Suddenly, two small glittering light beings appeared. It was the angels. As their friends got closer, the children saw the fairy angels' tiny faces, tiny wings, tiny angel hands, and they also noticed that they were smiling. "We're so sad we're being bullied. What should we do?" said Miguel.
The angels said, "Don't worry. We can help you."
Then both angels began to sing the following words.
"Oh, little girl and little boy, listen to our song of joy. Play with Mother Nature like a toy. Bring her air, it is so fair. Climb her mountains if you dare. Be like the tree, so strong and free. Birds come sing for you and me. Be strong, children, be strong. In this life there is some wrong. Be strong, children, be strong. And if our heart is full of love, we can forgive a bully shove. Be strong, be strong, be strong."
The children applauded and giggled with happiness.
"Yay, yay, now we know how to love every day. Yay, yay, we will love every day."
From the distance, the children heard,
"Come home to eat, come home to eat."
"Angels, angels, we have to go, but we'll see you here tomorrow," they said, as they ran home through the fields of flowers.
Ever since they heard that song, they would ask the angels and the tree questions about life, questions about the other kids at school, and they told Mother Nature all of their problems.
This quiet and peaceful way of handling their stress was turning out to be wonderful, restful, heartwarming. And one day, they went to school, and the other kids treated them so nicely. There was no bullying, no bad language, no negative comments, no hitting, no name-calling. It felt like something wonderful had happened.
To celebrate, they ate
a special afternoon snack while reporting the good news to their magic tree, who said,
"You know, those angels that you did see?
They will always be. They will always be."
The end.